Hello guys, welcome back once again. This is Jagrat here, and today I am going to cover another interesting topic. I mean that this is a very common interview question, what is the difference between interface and abstract class? Okay, so I have already told you the concept of interface. Okay, when I told you how to implement multiple inheritance. Okay. So you can see here concept of interface and multiple inheritance. So in this session, I will tell you the implementation of abstract class also. And at the end of this session, I will show you some theoretical points regarding interface and abstract class like this. Okay. So let me firstly remind you the concept of interface. Okay, what is interface and how can we implement it? Okay, so let me show you. So if you remember that I told you the example of US motor and Indian motor. Okay, so these are our parent interface, and there is a class that is audi.java. Okay, so this is the child class of these both interfaces. So this achieves the concept of multiple inheritance, that there is a one child class and there are more than one parent interfaces for this one child class. Okay, so you can see here we already defined the one interface like US motor. Okay, and in this particular US motor we defined some rules. Okay, we defined some rules here only. You can see here only method prototype is there. Okay, we did not define any implementation body. Same case you can see here in the Indian motor also, we defined only method over type. We did not define any implementation body. Okay, but in audi.java we implemented all those methods of interfaces. Okay, you can see here I told you already this concept. If you did not watch my that session, then please watch so that you can clearly understand the concept of interface. Okay, so this is the concept of interface. Okay, now let me told you the concept of abstract class. Okay, so guys, I will convert the same program into the abstract class. Okay, so let's see how can we convert this. So let me create an abstract class like US motor. Okay, US motor 1, because I have already defined the US motor class in my this package. So now I am defining the, let me cancel this. And I am defining a different class that is US motor 1. Okay, I am not selecting this public static void main because I am going to design this particular abstract class. Okay, so guys, you can see here. So currently this class is normal class, but if you want to convert into abstract class, then we have to insert a keyword abstract like this. So guys, now this is the abstract class. So before proceeding towards the coding implementation, I would like to tell you that both abstract class as well as interfaces achieve the concept of abstraction. Okay, So now what is this term abstraction? So abstraction means hiding the complexity from the user. Okay. You saw that in this particular interface, we defined only method prototype. Okay. We did not define any implementation logic. Okay. So in the same case, guys, in the abstract class, we defined some abstracts method as well as non-abstracts method. Okay. You can see here in the interface, only abstract methods are present. Okay. There is no non-abstract methods because we did not define any implementation logic. Okay, so I am talking here in terms of abstraction. Abstractions mean hiding the complexity from the normal user. Okay, so here I am defining, you know, one abstract method. So public abstract void start. Okay, so guys, this is our abstract method and this is the main prerequisite of any abstract class. Any abstract class must have at least one abstract method. Okay, it can also, guys, non-abstract method also, like this. Let us suppose I am creating another method. So guys, here I am also going to write the implementation logic. Okay, like this. Let us suppose US motor 1 stop method. Okay, so just concentrate right now on the coding part and then I will again explain all those things. Okay, let us suppose another method like refuel. Okay, and here US motor 1 refuel method, like this. Okay, so guys, these are non-abstract methods because I am writing the implementation logic also. So non-abstract method. Okay, so this is the first difference, that any particular abstract class has both abstract as well as non-abstract method. It may contain both abstract as well as non-abstract method, but any interface must have only abstract methods. Okay, so guys, this is the first difference you can see here. Here, abstract as well as non-abstract, both methods are present. Okay, so this is the, I designed, you know, one, you can say abstract class. Okay, now let me design another class, that is OD1. Okay, and let me just click on this finish. So guys, you can see here, currently this class OD1 and this abstract class US Motors has no relationship. Okay, so how can we make the relationship? With the extends keyword. So this OD1 extends US Motors, motor 1. Okay, so now this is a relationship that this US motor 1 is the parent class and this body 1 is the child class. So this is the another difference, guys. Okay, so between the class we use the keyword extends. If you want to establish a relationship between child class and parent abstract class, then extends keyword should be used. But if you can see here, if you want to relationship if you want to define the relationship between interface and the another class, then implements keyword must be used. Okay guys, so this is the second difference. Okay, so this is the difference, and you can see here guys, it is giving you some error. So let's see what is this error. The type OD1 must implement the inherited abstract method US motor 1 start. Guys, I told you that at the time of interface that these are the basic rules, and if we want to implement, or we can say if we want to open the OD branch in US motor, then we have to, you know, cover all the rules as well as regulations of the US motor. So same case here, if you want to extend the OD1, okay, I mean we can say if you want to inherit the properties from the US motors, then we have to follow all the rules. Okay, so what are the rules here? Start method. Okay, so we have to implement this, that's why it is giving you error. So add implemented method. So you can see here, this is added in our code, and guys, here I can write logic like OD1, okay, and start method. So what actually says, it says that US motor 1, this particular class US motor 1 defined a logic, okay, defined a rule, okay, it does not implement any logic, it only defines the rules. But what actually OD1 is doing, this OD1 class is implementing their own logic for rule start. Okay, so it inherits the, you know, this start method logic, but what is the, you know, implementation logic, it is decided by OD1 class. Okay guys, so this is the, you know, main thing. Now this particular OD1 class has their own method also, like let me copy this and let me paste. Okay, so here let us suppose method is mileage. Okay, so OD1 mileage method like this. Okay, now we are going to declare the another class, that is the test class. So test abstract. Okay, and in this we have to, you know, click on this public static void main. Now guys, same thing, we are going to define the object of this child class, that is OD1 class. Okay, so OD1, let us suppose A is equal to new OD1. Okay, we created the object. So guys, can we access a dot start method? Yes, I told you this is the start method and this is also the start method. Okay, so this is overridden method, so overridden method will be called. Okay, can we start a dot stop method? Yes. So guys, you can say, see here, this is OD1 is the child class. So child class can inherit all the properties. I mean, child class can, you know, acquire all the properties of its parent class. Okay, so a dot stop method, yes, we can access. Can we access a dot refuel method? Yes, we can access, because it is present in parent class. Can we access a dot mileage? Yes, we can access a dot mileage, because it is itself present in OD1 class. Okay guys, so let me run this and let's see the output. See, OD1 start method, then US motor 1 stop method, US motor 1 refuel method, and OD1 mileage method. Okay guys, I told you what is this concept. Static type, static time polymorphism. Okay, I told you so many times this concept. Now again, dynamic time polymorphism. How can we achieve it? So we can create the object for this child class. Let me copy this, and we are going to refer by, I mean, this particular object is referred by parent class. So what is our parent class? US motors, US motor 1. Okay, US motor 1, and let us suppose US is equal to new OD1. So guys, this is allowed, also allowed. Okay, now can we access US dot start? Yes. So which method will be called? Overridden method will be called. I told you this concept so many times. Okay, can we access US dot stop? Yes, because it is present in the, you know, parent class. Okay, can we access US dot refuel? Yes. Okay, so we can access US dot refuel. But guys, can we access US dot mileage? No. See, US dot mileage, we cannot access US dot mileage. Okay, why? Because it is the property of OD1 class. And remember the concept of inheritance. Child class can acquire the properties of parent class. Okay, but parent class cannot acquire the properties of child class. So same concept here. Okay, so let me run this. Let me write here so that you can clearly understand. Yeah. Okay, so let me run this program. You can see here. See, OD1 start method. Okay, so overridden method. Overridden method is called. See, overridden method is called. Okay, and then US motor stop 1 and US motor 1 refuel method. Okay guys, so this is the another concept. Now I am going to tell you some theoretical differences. So the first difference is, in interface we achieve full abstraction, while, you know, in abstract class, let me create this, correct this. In abstract class we achieve partial abstractions. Okay, so guys, this is true. I told you that in interface we wrote only abstract methods. Okay, there is no implementation logic in under any of the method. Okay, but if you will see this abstract class, then you can see here we have both methods, abstract method as well as non-abstract method. That's why we can say that in abstract class we achieve partial abstraction, okay, but in interface we achieve full abstraction. Okay, so guys, this is the first difference. Second difference is interface can have only abstract method. Okay, so I told you this is the, you know, interface, only abstract methods are present. There is no implementation logic in any of the method. While in abstract class, abstract and non-abstract method both may present. Okay, so guys, this is the second difference. Interface has only static and final variables. Okay guys, so let's see this concept. Okay, so when I told you interface, then I declared, you know, this variable. Okay, so this variable is by default static in nature. You can see here, static in nature as well as final in nature. Okay, I told you. So that's why you can see here in interface has only static and final variables. But guys, in abstract class can have final as well as non-final, static, non-static, any type of variable you can declare. Okay, so let us suppose I will declare here minimum age. Okay, so let us suppose I will declare like this. Okay guys, so this is also okay. Okay, if you will write like this, static int min age is equal to 20. So guys, this is also allowed. You can see here we can declare static variables also. Okay, and if you will write like this, that final int min age is equal to 20. So guys, you can see here this is also allowed. So we can declare either static, non-static, final, non-final method, any type of, you know, variables we can declare here. But in interface, variables are by default static and final in nature. Okay, so this is the another difference. The next difference is abstract keyword is used to declare abstract class. Okay, so I told you, if we want to define, I mean declare the abstract class, then we use abstract keyword. An interface, we use interface keyword. Okay, so this is the another difference. An abstract class can be extended using keywords extends. I told you guys, this is the our child class, and if you want to establish a relationship between child class and abstract class, then we use the extends keyword. While in interface, we use implements keyword. Okay, so this is the another difference. Then a Java abstract class can have class member like private and protected, while members of Java interface are public by default. So I told you that you can see here variables are by default public in nature. Okay, and in the, you know, abstract class it can be, you know, private as protected. Okay, so private also like this. Okay, and the last is, you know, interface supports multiple inheritance. I told you that this particular interface we designed to achieve the, you know, multiple inheritance, but abstract class does not support multiple inheritance. Okay guys, so these are the some basic points, some basic differences between interface and abstract class. Okay, So for each and every point, I told you the implementation also. Okay, so I wrote the same program previously to implement the interface concept, and now I wrote the same program to implement, you know, abstract class also. Okay, so with the help of this, you can clearly understand that how can we convert one program into the another program. Okay, so guys, this is completed. So let me mark it as completed. Okay, so guys, please practice this. Okay, this is a very, you know, common interview question, that interface versus abstract class. So in the next session, we will see the exception handling in Java. Okay, like try, catch, block, throw, throws. So these are the some another concepts in core Java that we need to see, because we will use all these concepts in the framework also. Okay, so if you really like this video, then please like, share and subscribe. Okay, see you in the next session. Bye bye.